Hello viewers, in this video we will be discussing on homing behavior in animals, a very interesting and important topic of BSc 6th semester zoology major course class. Before going to the topic, I like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to Zoological Society of Assam for giving me opportunity to participate in this novel initiative of online classes for the benefit of the students. Aim of this presentation is to throw light on what is homing behavior, role of navigation and orientation, cues and mechanisms used for homing by animals, and homing behavior in different animals, and in conclusion, importance of the knowledge of animals' homing behavior. Most animals show specific adaptation to a particular habitat, and if they are displaced from their normal home range, it will be important for them to be able to return. Homing is the inherent ability of an animal to navigate its return to its original location through unfamiliar areas. This location may be either a home territory or a breeding spot. Homing animals exhibit a very persistent motivation to return home despite the obstacles and difficulties. It occurs in a wide variety of species and ranges from the relatively simple task of returning home after foraging to the complexities of a migration from one home to another. A well-developed homing ability is particularly valuable in saving time and energy when large distances have to be covered and when the starting point is unfamiliar. The complexity and sophistication of the sensory mechanisms used in homing suggest that there has been considerable pressure of natural selection and that homing is very important in the life of many animals. Role of navigation and orientation. Navigation refers to the ability of planning and controlling one's movement from one place to another. It requires knowing one's current location on Earth, the location of the desired goal, and an ability to calculate travel directions to get from here to there. On the other hand, the distinct preferences shown by animals to depart in one particular direction is known as orientation. To return home successfully across an ocean or a mountain barrier requires a considerable feat of navigation. The homing animal has not only to set off in the correct direction, but has also to maintain a correct course despite changing weather conditions. Successful homing skill thus demands considerable navigation and orientation abilities on part of the animal concerned. Examples of homing behavior. Adelie penguins forage far out at sea and are able to return to their nest even if displaced by storms. The green turtle, which breeds on Ascension Island, feeds off the coast of Brazil about 1500 km away. The adult female turtle visits the island, which is only 7.5 km wide and is in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, and lays their eggs in the sand of the beaches. They then return to their feeding grounds, where they remain for several years before returning to the same beach to lay another clutch of eggs. California newts spend the summer months underground, forage widely in the forest in the autumn and winter, and migrate to their particular breeding grounds in the spring. They breed in pools in mountain streams and return to the same pool each year. Next is the cues and mechanisms used for homing by animals. The key element to understanding homing behavior is determining which cues provide the directional information that allows animals to move between their home and other locations. Animals may utilize a variety of cues and mechanisms to determine the location of its home site. Different species may use these cues in different orders of priority, and some cues may always be used in preference to others. Also, animals may use environmental information hierarchically, so that one type of homing information is important when they are distant from their home, and others become more important as they come closer to their goal. Many sense organs are known to be implicated in navigation and homing, including electromagnetic senses, chemical senses, and various aspects of vision. A brief review of the cues used by animals for homing is presented as follows. First is the topographic features or landmarks. Memory of the contours surrounding the destination is one common method used for homing by animals. Visual landmarks are used by number of animals in locating the exact position of their home. This means in familiar areas, they will use landmarks such as roads, rivers, or mountains when flying, or islands and other landmarks while swimming. These topographic features may be particularly important for navigation to a precise breeding or wintering locality. Radar images show that migrating bird flocks drift off courses in a strong crosswind, except for flocks that travel along distinct landmarks such as rivers, coastlines, or mountain ridges. Here, I want to cite Tinbergen's experiment with digger wasps as an example of use of topographic features or landmarks as a cue for homing. Nico Tinbergen explored digger wasps' ability to return to the entrance tunnel of its nest site containing a developing larva. The wasps catches bees on hunting trips and return with this food to the offspring. While the wasps was in the burrow, Tinbergen placed a circle of pine cones around the entrance. When the wasps emerged, it completed several circles around the entrance areas before flying off. Tinbergen then moved the pine cones to the side of the nest and waited for the wasps to return from hunting. Upon return, the wasps flew to the center of the pine cone circle, even though that had been moved during her absence. Next is the chemical cues. These are the most useful cues in case of aquatic animals homing. Let us take the example of salmon fish. The life cycle of a salmon begins in a freshwater stream or river that dumps into the ocean. After spending 4 or 5 years in the ocean and reaching sexual maturity, many salmon return to the same stream they were born into spawn. There are several hypotheses on how salmon are able to do this. One hypothesis states that salmon retain an imprint of the odor of their natal stream as they are migrating downstream. Using this memory of the odor, they are able to return to the same stream years later. Another smell-related hypothesis states that the young salmon release a pheromone as they migrate downstream and are able to return the same stream years later by smelling the pheromone they released. Another example of animal that uses chemical cue is limpet. Limpets feed their shell to one specific spot on a rock. A close fit is critical to withstand the impact of waves when submerged and prevent desiccation when exposed. Scraping algae from the rock surface, they travel from their home site, leaving behind a chemical trail. By reversing direction on this trail, they are able to return to the very site they came from. Next is the Earth's magnetic field. Many animals use magnetic orientation based on the Earth's magnetic field to find their way home. It is believed that animals imprint on the unique magnetic field that exists in their natal area and then use this information to return years later. This idea is known as the geomagnetic imprinting hypothesis. Important aspects of the process include, number one, the learning occurs during a particular critical period, usually early in the life of the animal. Number two, the effect lasts a long time. And number three, the effects cannot be easily modified. For natal homing, the concept is that animals like sea turtles and salmon imprint on the magnetic field of their home area when young and then use this information to return years later. The concept was developed to explain how sea turtle and salmon can return to their home areas after migrating hundreds or thousands of kilometers away. Celestial objects. Many animals are known to use the location of the sun and stars to navigate and find their way home. Displaced marbled newts, for example, can only home when stars are visible. Another example comes from Sahara Desert and which are scavengers and forage for the corpses of insects and other arthropods which have succumbed to the heat stress of their desert environment. This ant ventures far from its burrow in the desert, which has almost no identifiable features. While venturing out, it periodically takes measurements of its angle in respect to the sun. In addition to obtaining information on outward directional angles, the ant appears to measure distances using an internal pedometer to count its steps. When the ant finds a dead insect, it calculates the shortest route back to the nest through vector averaging. Honeybees, too, use the position of the sun as a navigational aid. When the sky is overcast, they obtain equivalent information from the pattern of polarization of the light in the sky. Homing behavior in bees. Honeybees, like many other animals, forage from a fixed location, the hive. This type of foraging, often termed central place foraging, imposes a requirement for good navigation abilities. The animal must be able to find its way back home after a foraging bout, which may take it away from visual or auditory contact with the nest and its residents. Honeybees may forage several kilometers from their hive, making them a good model species for studying navigation in central place foraging. Honeybees may forage several kilometers, information used in home-based navigation can be divided into two categories, egocentric information and geocentric information. Egocentric information is generated internally by the animal and is independent of its immediate surroundings. Internal calculations of the distance and direction traveled, which are used in path integration, are examples of egocentric information. And geocentric information includes landmarks and any map information available to the animal. Honeybees primarily use path integration in making their way to and from foraging sites. Dense information provides outgoing bees with a distance and directions to be traveled. Flight direction is determined by a sun compass orientation and distance of flight by an internal odometer that measures the rate at which visual images flow past the eyes. Odors provide supplementary information. Once a route is learned, bees incorporate visual landmarks when they make repeat trips to a foraging site. The return trip is governed by path integration as well, but also may be informed by landmarks. Two basic models have been proposed to explain landmark incorporating orientation of bee in homing are: number one, snapshot memory put forward by Cartwright and Collett, and number two, cognitive maps by Tolman. Snapshot memory. This model proposes that the bee remembers a series of visual images of the landscape as it passes. It also remembers images of particularly prominent landscape features. These images can then be compared with the actual landscape surroundings the bee at any given moment. Ultimately, the bee may be able to use the landmark snapshot information, projecting its position when it is displaced to an unfamiliar location but still in view of an array of familiar landmarks. Cognitive maps. More complex is the cognitive map model, which states that the bees construct a relatively complete neural representation of the landscape based on its experiences while flying. Test of the cognitive map model requires that displaced bees calculate a novel route home based on their memory of the landscape map. The allocentric model for snapshot use begins to converse with the cognitive map model, but remains a simpler explanation for orientation and homing in honeybees. Homing in pigeon. Homing behavior in pigeon is interesting because for thousands of years, humans have used homing pigeons to return messages back to home base by attaching them to the bird's legs. The homing pigeon has been selectively bred to be able to return to its home over extremely long distances. As a pigeon generally returns to its own nest and its own mate, human handlers have selectively bred subsets of birds that were particularly good at this task. Homing flight from as far as 1000 kilometers have been recorded by exceptional birds at average flying speed of around 50 kilometers per hour. How do pigeons find their way home when deposited in an unfamiliar location? To do this, they must have two kinds of information. The first, called map sense, is their geographical location. The second, compass sense, is the bearing they need to fly from their own location in order to reach their home. If either information source is disrupted, then homing fails or is delayed. The map sense. In familiar surroundings, location from which pigeon is previously homed or landscape through which they were flown. Landmarks play a predominant role in homing. Pigeon learn visual features of the landscape and uses these visual features to determine their current position relative to their roost. When released in completely unfamiliar environment, pigeons are known to use olfactory cues. It is now known that in their roost, they associate odors with wind directions. When released, they assess the odor of their new location and extrapolate the map location from their roost gained knowledge of winds and odors. Pigeons is visually unfamiliar territory whose sense of smell has been disrupted, have a great deal of difficulty homing. Similarly, if the roost is blocked from winds and provided with filtered air, homing fails. Pigeons, in fact, home better if they have some time to olfactory experience their new surroundings prior to release. The compass sense. The primary compass information of pigeons come from its position of the sun in the sky. By integrating their internal clocks with the sun's position, they compensate for the apparent movement of the sun across the sky. Like migrating birds, the pigeon's sun compass also interact with a magnetic compass. Next, homing in mammals. Mammals also use path integration system to return to its home. Mammals can create cognitive map and update it constantly by remembering landmarks and storing information about their locations in hippocampus part of their brain. Familiar examples of homing among domestic animals are cats, dogs that return home after having been released many miles away. In case of small mammals, bats are known for homing behavior. They famously orient at night by echolocation. Their flight ability and navigation across terrain, particularly in short homing distances, is probably based on memory, vision, and echolocation. Echolocation is an active form of orientation in which sender emits sounds and then listen to reflected echoes of those sounds to form images of their surroundings in their brains. From the study of big brown bat, it is found that they can migrate up to 20 kilometers north from their home roost by using Earth's magnetic field and systematic gradients guided by olfaction. Wood mouse are the first non-human animal to be observed using movable landmarks to migrate. While foraging, they pick up and distribute leaves and twigs which they use as landmark during exploration. In case of large mammals, hoofed mammals in Africa, as for example zebra and giraffe, moves in large numbers with the availability of water and forage. Their migration tend to follow traditional routes. Carnivores and omnivores in case of mammals show advanced homing ability than the herbivores. As for example, gray wolves homed back to their home pen from 282 km away using their hearing sense. Black bears and wolves use scent gradients that aided orientation. Conclusion. The knowledge on homing behavior of animal is important as it can provide information regarding migratory patterns, home range size, territoriality, etc., helpful for the conservation of endangered species. An understanding of foraging behavior in animals can lead to an understanding of forest regeneration. For example, knowledge of honeybees' foraging behavior is important for plant breeding and propagation. Friends, for more details, you can go through the books and research papers which are cited herein. Here are my contact details. Dear students, if you have any query, feel free to contact me. Before I conclude, I would like to thank Professor J.C. Kolita sir for his inspiring words and Professor Monideep Raj sir for his active support while making this presentation. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.